While the water flosser portion of the toothbrush itself may have some disadvantages, it also has some cool advantages. I'm Rick Buck. I've been a dentist for 14 years. I cover all things oral health related, so subscribe if you have teeth and you want to keep them. In this video, I will cover the Waterpik toothbrush and show you how well it removes my plaque when I stain it pink. When I first reviewed this toothbrush over a year ago, I thought it was amazing, but I wanted to follow up now on this brush because I have gotten a little bit better and more consistent in reviewing toothbrushes and the methods I use to do so. Meanwhile, while I'm testing out these brushes and brushing, I will tell you the things I like and don't like about the toothbrush. Let's start how we always do by staining all the plaque in my mouth pink. Now, the first thing to note about the Waterpik toothbrush is its design. It combines a water flosser and an electric toothbrush in one, so you can do both at the same time, which is an exciting idea for at least for a dentist like me, because in theory, that would cut down on time and combine the power of two different oral hygiene techniques in one. Okay, now the brush itself does sonic movements at 30,000 vibrations a minute, which is 1,000 less than other popular brands and 3,000 less than my favorite toothbrush. But ultimately, that's not too far off from the other brands that I like. The pressure of the water flosser is the most important feature of the water flosser component of this toothbrush, and any water flosser out there for that matter. The pressure in this water flosser is a max of 100 PSI, which is less than 160 that you would get from the most powerful water flosser that I've used so far. And I recommend, if you want to use just a water flosser, to use that one, because once again, its pressure is the most. You should watch the video I have on the effectiveness of water flossers alone, but I'll give you a little spoiler. I'm not a big fan of them, but you can see the results there in that video as to why. Enough about the numbers though, let's talk about how practical this toothbrush is and if it cleans the plaque off my teeth well. The first thing you will notice about the water flosser is that toothpaste is kind of obsolete with these toothbrushes. It washes right off and likely does very little. The second thing you will notice is that this thing is messy. You have to constantly lean over the sink, and even then it still kind of sprays, gets everywhere, gets on your mirror, and takes off your wife because it leaves lots of spots. I'm only kidding, my wife doesn't get mad at me, but I'm sure in the back of her mind she wishes when I use this that I didn't use it. In fact, it's so messy for me to do this video, I had to rig a bowl to be just under my chin and just let the water flow out. But yeah, it is a mess. But then again, it is just water, so you decide. The next thing you'll notice if you use this, and the next thing I noticed, is that they don't sell it with a big enough basin to water floss the whole mouth at the higher settings. So if you're water flossing at 100 PSI, you're either going to have to use a lower setting or refill it halfway through, or rig it under a faucet to have the water pouring into it as you're brushing, so it's kind of refilling the water as you're brushing. I don't get why they don't just sell a bigger basin. I mean, I'm sure it has something to do with shelf space and bigger boxes and things like that, but I think they could think of something so that you can at least brush fully on one basin. Okay, now I kind of knock it, but we still don't know what the water flosser in conjunction with the toothbrush is gonna do. Now, while the water flosser portion of the toothbrush itself may have some disadvantages, it also has some cool advantages. You can add fluoride rinse to the water basin and to the solution to get the fluoride benefits, since you won't be getting the fluoride benefits from the toothpaste. And you might want to, since the toothpaste will not be that great for you. One thing some other people do is add ozone water to the basin. That is a good idea if for some reason you want to destroy the bacteria colonies in your mouth and you have a lot of problem with just tooth decay. Now, I realize talking about ozone water might be foreign to people, but I'm just saying this because people that want holistic methods of cleaning their teeth and brushing the plaque away, ozone water is a really good remedy for that. It takes a lot of time to do, but it is an option. Anyways, do the ozone water and adding things to it at your own risk, not at my recommendation. Okay, let's look at the results. Now, I did this a few different days, and all the days I kind of got the same results. I know these are just one day, but the results are not that great, especially on my back teeth, which may be why I was not evaluating it that well the last time I tested this toothbrush out. my last video, you can only really kind of see the front teeth, which it does fairly well. In fact, I was so bothered by this on this day that I went back in with mediocre floss to break up the plaque, just in case my plaque was just really tenacious for some reason that day. And then I went in again and just focused on the lower right with the Waterpik toothbrush. I wanted to see if I can get some of those spots, if I just focused on the one spot. And the results were better, but still not great. So unfortunately, it actually doesn't even perform as good as some of the other popular high-end models of electric toothbrushes. And as you can see, and as I've shown you here, I mean, even when I focus it right on a spot where I know plaque is at, and you won't even have that luxury unless you're using a plaque disclosing agent, it just still does not perform as well as my favorite toothbrush or even some of the other high-end toothbrushes. And I have in an affiliate link in the description of this video that toothbrush, and it will get you $30 off. Also, links to this brush and the pink dye are in the description of this video. Basically, the toothbrush does not accomplish what their advertising tries to infer, which is that it's even more effective than flossing. Now, whatever that means and whatever jargon they use to get around it, it still seems kind of like false advertising to me, because it in fact doesn't get near as far in between the teeth than other brushes I've tested, and especially not flosses. You still definitely have to floss if you use this toothbrush. So with a $200 price tag, in my opinion, you are way overpaying, especially compared to my favorite toothbrush. And I'm really sad about this because I thought this was a great toothbrush, just a messy toothbrush. But as I tested out this second time, it's not even getting that great of results, especially on my back teeth. So now, if you want to see how you can get your mouth cleaner, then you should check out my video on the best daily brushing and flossing routine. The results are mind-blowing. Everyone should watch that at least once. Now, all the links to the products I used in this video are below in the description of the YouTube video, including the plaque staining tablets that I used. Subscribe if you have teeth and want to keep them.